Hey guys, welcome back to another late night here on the East Coast. How y'all doing? I am actually on fire. Gotta be said, it's finally hot now in Canada, and again, we're in a stuffy apartment building on the fourth floor with no heat, no way for heat to escape. Absolutely no amounts of ventilation and no AC at all. So, amazing. What can you do? Anyway, I picked up the Mercenaries expansion. And we're going to go for the Torians. The Torians are pretty cool in the lore, so I like that. It still blows my mind that Galsave is like one of the only 4X games to actually have a single-player campaign. But yeah. So, twice made slaves of the Drengan Empire, the Torians now strive to rebuild their once-great civilization. Though still untrusting of other races, they're willing to work even with the most undesirable forces to secure their future. Yeah, so Torians are actually, well, last time they got enslaved by the Drengan, they were just being harvested for their meat, much like, you know, Abe's Odyssey, or Oddworld, if you will. So they are amphibious, they can colonize water worlds early game with no penalty, and they can terraform one extra water tile each tech age. Which is just nice. It gives them a bonus to planets that most people can't get access to early. And discreet. So we receive a free random tier 1 mercenary every game when we first encounter the Bazaar. I don't know how mercenaries are going to play, so we'll see if that's a good thing or if that's a bad thing. We're clever, so we get 20% more research. Content, so we have extra morale. It's not too much, but it's okay. Fertile, growth 20%. I mean, that's nice. Farmers, 10% food, that's 10% more population, sort of. And we're brittle, so we have a penalty to our strategic repair. Not the most amazing race traits, certainly if you're playing a militaristic game. These guys right here, the Yor, are easily the most powerful in my opinion. The Drengans are okay, but the Yor are just amazing. You got manufacturing, research, economical, and more capacity. But a little penalty to trade routes, which I don't really care about anyway. But we're going to do the Torians because I like their fluff, and I think they're cool, and this guy looks like a badass now. Torians used to look really stupid in Galsiv 2. But we'll try and maybe make this work. I'm really hoping we can. These also would be a decent militaristic faction. But we're not going to play as the Arsians. They are a new faction to mercenaries. They're not new to Galsiv, though. They're in Galsiv 2. So I guess we can talk about them as we're going to be facing them. The Arsian Empire is a noble race with a rich history of neutrality. Liberated by the Terran Alliance, they now strive to rebuild their empire, vowing to never be subjugated again. They now honor their warriors above all others. So they have morale penalty, they're strong in fighting, they're tough, resilient, blah 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 blah. They are organized so they do have bigger fleets than most people. But let's give the Torians a go here. So since we're playing as this race, we do have their unique tech tree. So that's kind of interesting. We also have their ship design and all that stuff. Again, we're going to play probably large is all right. Loose clusters, I think, is the best. I felt like this was a very nice galaxy size. Someday we may attempt something larger. Something smaller, I feel, is just too cramped. Master of Orion 2, actually, I checked out the recording just a little bit, seeing what I did last time, see if I did anything wrong. And I picked a medium galaxy, and I normally pick the large one. Because medium galaxies are just a little too cramped. We're all right beside each other. There's no room for stuff like that. I'm just going to keep all the things on, and I would like to play against the Arsians because they're new Airquats. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we'll do this, I think. Just have them be random. Hopefully the Snaggly don't get put in the game, but we'll see what happens. Random team here. I don't really know what's up with that. Or why some of them are on different difficulties. I don't know why that is. Well, let's bump them all up. You know, we could probably put them all on gifted, actually. Did pretty good last time. We'll see what happens here. Might be biting off a little bit more than we can chew. But that's okay. Add in the snaggly. Well, we have random, so we might be playing against the snaggly. We might. Hopefully we're also playing against the Drangen. As they're... Do we... Alright, guys. We'll throw some guaranteeds in. We'll put the Drangen as... You know, we're trying to get back at them. That'd be kind of cool. And you guys want the... Snaggly. Put them in as well. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, that's fine. Snaggly in our game, go full military? Oh, please no. Please no. Welcome back, Herbie. So even though we're starting... Nah, we lost. It was pretty tight, though. Even though we are starting Galsif 3, I'm still probably going to be playing Master of Orion 2 tomorrow. Because I want to do that. It's probably not a good idea to do it right now, as I'm tired, so my strategy is not going to be as good, because I haven't played that game in so long. Whereas Galsif 3 I played very recently, so my memory on how to play the game is very fresh. Yeah, it's all good. You don't have to win every game. I had fun playing it, and that's all that matters. I'm actually melting, though. Alright. So we already read this here. The Torian regime has lost much, but their spirit remains unbroken. They've also gained the favor of powerful mercenary forces and have learned to use them to great advantage. As a race that first evolved to sentience in the oceans of their homeworld, they also have the advantage of being able to colonize aquatic worlds and are hospitable to most. They're normally the guys you push around in the first two games. In this one, though, not so much. Whoa! Whoopity-doo, guys. We have very nice-looking ships, though. I actually have really like this design. Wow! Please, camera, you're gonna give me a frickin' heart attack. Alright. Let's go ahead and have our scout auto explore. And this is our survey ship. That's a class 8 right there. Wow. That is really nice. Well, there you go, guys. Can't argue with a class 8. I mean, you can. But you shouldn't look a gift horse in the mouse. You shouldn't look them in the mouse either. They don't like that. Okay, so we'll just have you on auto survey. Which will be fine. Okay. I think I'm actually just going to rush this guy here. And we're going to need another colony ship for there. Let's go ahead and check out my shipyard, though. Ah, the hermit crab is our cargo, right, and the spawner, right on. So we need one colony ship for sure, potentially two. ET, phone up, some merch to kick your face in. I like it, Bard. We're also going to need another scout. Maybe two scouts, I kind of like to know what's going on in the universe. That said, though, we're going to go ahead and modify this scout, make it a little bit cheaper, potentially. So, the ripple, let's use this design here. What do you have on you, you damn fool? Alright, so you have increased sensor range. Don't need that. Aquatic support. Extra ship range is good. You can't argue with that, really. Alright. So, we'll save this as the Ripple M2. Apparently it's a prototype for some reason. We don't have Promethean hyperdrives on the damn thing, so sure. But it is going to make it cheaper, and it is also going to make it less maintenance, which is nice. So how much for a Riffle Mark II? So yeah, you see here, we shave off 3 turns, which is really nice. And you do start the game with a lot of money, like a lot of money. So it's very tempting to rush by those. Probably gonna rush by one of them. Let's look at our home world. So we get 5% extra moves. Doesn't really help us too much, although it is increased military, which is cool. Bonus to research, manufacturing. Right. Okay, our homeworld is a massive piece of shit. Absolutely massive piece of shit. Potentially the worst homeworld I've ever seen in my life. So, there's that. Wow. Okay, well, we do start with aquatic biospheres. So, how do we fix it? The reason is because our homeworld's being demolished. Now, every tech level, we do get a new biosphere, so eventually we'll be able to turn this into a very nice place. Very nice is, of course, asterisk, but that's late game stuff. We're going to want to talk about where we place these a little bit. First off, we're going to need two factories down here. Probably our best bets for that. It doesn't have a lot of, like, nice tile bonuses, and they're in weird spots, so it's not ideal. We'll put it that way. We're going to want our learning center right there. That's where our research goes. We're going to need farms, maybe here. That's where I put our birthing pool, sorry. Oh, birthing pool is just increased growth. No, I don't need growth rate, I need food. So we don't have farms yet, okay. Interesting, I'm gonna have to get used to this different tech tree as well. Aside from that, we're not going influence, so I'm not gonna worry about the consulate. Potentially just grab two more factories, call it a day, and cry myself to sleep. I think that's what we do. We're gonna make this our military slash production sort of capital. It doesn't, though. So here's how this works, right? That is your growth rate. So that is how much new population you get every turn. Whereas food affects your population cap. Do you know what I mean? So growth, like, we already have a massive bonus of growth just from our racial bonuses, which again aren't very geared. But that's okay. So right here would be pretty good to get our first tile. Just get a nice little triple manufacturing. I want to get it here, though, because eventually this is going to be... We might be doing some sort of military cheese stuff on this planet. And we can always use that for research temporarily. It's hard to say, though. Here's okay, because we're going to be using that tile as well, so... We'll get all this stuff going. We're going to rush by our first factory. We didn't start with all the money that we did last time, sadly. But, oh well. We'll get that thing rushed out. And we're going to set a manufacturing focus. We don't need the money right now, and we don't need the research. But we do need to pump out ships and all that kind of cool stuff. Birthing pool, we're amphibious. That's right, man, yeah. Hello! Alright, so amphibious infrastructure, Xenofactory school... Okay, better antimatter power plant. That's really, really good. Wow, that is an amazing... So it requires this one antimatter, which sucks because, again, antimatter is hard to find, and we're going to want to use it for missiles as we're militaristic, but those adjacency bonuses are nothing to laugh at. Wow. Starbase Factory, Starbase Laboratory, both pretty cool. Colonial Hospital, Planetary Soil Upgrade. There's our farm. So we want to go here, actually, for the hydroponic farm. I think we're going to be grabbing the factory first. That's just a very safe bet. Universal Translator would be nice. We're not worrying about making friends right now. Let's go with amphibious infrastructure. We'll get planetary settlement and see how we're going from there. So we're going to put a little bit of... I mean, I like the culture, the influence thing. So we are going to put a little bit of effort into it, but not a ton. So we'll, of course, have this be the Metalliturtle system. Wow, if I spell that right. Anyway. Let's see what's going on here. First colony. Yeah, we know. Animals to tame. The terrain of this planet has proven very challenging for our conventional ground vehicles to deal with, and some colonists have begun capturing and taming a hardy local species of marsupial to use for hopping around between buildings and colonies. That's cool. The animals are well suited for work, but don't seem to be suffering. But there have been a few accidents, and animal rights activists across the galaxy are demanding the practice be banned. So, we can get plus 10% approval on this planet, plus 10% manufacturing, or plus 15% manufacturing. Would the animals work harder if they were suffering? See if we can find ways to make the animals suffer. Yeah? Alright. If the animals aren't overly suffering, what's the harm? And pragmatic is the nice one, but I'm going to go for manufacturing because we don't know which way we're building this yet. Ultra spice. Hyper cocaine is in, everybody. Alright. This is another terrible planet. We'll eventually be good, though, with this here. This will make a very potentially good planet at some point. Unfortunately, we're not quite there. We don't have economic buildings, so I can't build those. We'll get two factories up over here. Yeah, kangaroos. No, we're whipping kangaroos. And are we becoming the people we hate? Is that what's happening? Maybe. Maybe we shouldn't do that. I don't know. We're going to put a manufacturing focus, as I'm not really doing much of anything else. And we'll rush by the first factory as per standard. So, this is something to talk about, our ideologies. Right now we have one malevolent, so we'll talk about which one here. But we can go for any of these trees. We already did benevolent, so I'd like to do pragmatic at least. Malevolent might have more military stuff. And again, I'm thinking of a... Yeah, in these games, always heavy manufacturing to get the planet off the ground. It can be seen as a waste of time, essentially, you know, getting a bunch of factories out and then later on going, oh, I don't want stuff there. But it's always easier to have factories and delete them than it is to have anything else. You've been doing pragmatic. Would you like me to do pragmatic so we can walk through that one together? Unfortunately, I feel like, I mean, I already have my malevolent pick right now, and it may be staying that way. So... Maybe we are evil bastards. Let's see what we get here. Alright, interesting. Interesting. No, it's not too bad. That's really good. That's pretty good. Okay. Alright, pragmatic's solid. It's pretty solid. There's a few things I wouldn't mind grabbing in here, but let's try and do a malevolent playthrough. Now again, you can splash into all of them. Much like in Civ, that you know, you can do whichever. However, how this works, and it's sort of like culture in Civ as well, if you want to think of it that way, is if you invest heavily, you're going to get better rewards, but it's very unlikely you're going to get very far in. So it's easier to skip between, especially in this game where it's cheaper to get upgrades for something that you have less points in. Unfortunately, the only way to get the far end stuff is by getting these very early on things like the Intimidation Center here, which will produce a point every 10 turns. I don't think we have anything else that will do that right now. So militaristic will give us a free frigate class warship. Don't need that right now. Intimidation center improvement. I don't know what this does. Intimidation center is capable of raising approval by force. When placed on a troublesome world, it will help shut up the whiners and reconfirm our reputation as a race that doesn't take shit guff from anyone. Alright. Uncharitable. So 10% increase to planetary income. That's huge, actually. Greed tree. I like it. Whoa! Oh my goodness! The greed tree? Oh, death furnaces. Oh man, alright. Oh, man. Alright, Malevolent is going to be what we go. That is, well, let's get our Intimidating first. That's what we gotta do. So we'll come back to this when we get our second point, but Intimidating, we want to start capitalizing on some of that stuff. You saw that, Nalakin? Oh my goodness. We'll talk about that later. That is beautiful. Plus two to approval. So it increases merciless culture production. Interesting. And morale plus 50%. Holy shit. That actually with our racial bonus is very strong. Means we're going to be able to have a higher population on our planets than normally you would. Which, of course, in turn means more research, more blurb, and more bloobity-bloo. Unfortunately, I rushed this factory, which is a bit of a mistake in hindsight. That should have been the Intimidation Center. Oh, no, I didn't. I rushed that one. Well, thank Frack. I was going to say, I don't know why I would have rushed that one. Alright, cool. Again, it's kind of weird, because... I mean, normally this... we're in a corner again. That's a bit frustrating. But normally this is the... friendly... I don't know if that's the word. The faction that gets pushed over a lot in the original games. But now we're the... sort of not-so-nice guys. I'm going to turn this guy off auto-survey. We'll pick stuff up later. But I really do want to scout out the planets. Because we need to do a snatch and grab as... when you play a militaristic race, you're sort of against the clock because people... now, it depends how you play. We do have a research bonus, but people are going to be better at us than everything, for the most part, because we're focusing on being able to take other people's stuff. So, not the end of the world, but, you know, it's not wonderful. What do we got here? Durantium, that's quite nice. Do we have access to Durantium refineries? We do. Okay. Unfortunately, we don't have a planet that sustains that kind of stuff. But, that's alright. And we didn't pick Wealthy this time, so we can't just rush by everything, ever. Yeah, this time we won't take shit. Last time we took a bit of shit. Capsule, what do you got for me? Greetings, Talaski Zentha. Welcome to the Galactic Bazaar. Oh, these are, yeah, the corks. It's interesting. They're not in this game, but they're in Galsif 2. You probably already realize it's a dangerous galaxy out there. The good news is the corks are here. They're ready to lend you a helping hand. We have several talented mercenaries available that are willing to help you out. We're even willing to offer you a free mercenary so you can see how useful they can be. But be quick, because supplies are limited. Well, that's very kind. Why don't you show us what you have to offer? Yeah. We surveyed an anomaly here. Oh, okay, so we got 25% more research here. Alien computational systems. We've had that several times before. Check out these sweet sheeps. Well, hopefully the game doesn't crash right now because we had a few events pop up at once. So we can pick a free one, right? And that's the idea. Oh, we get a random free one. So the random free one we got is an equipped colony ship. Interesting. So, we just got a free colony ship, which saves us 29 turns. Not super what I wanted. I was hoping for a combat one, but that's okay. So, you do have to pay their costs, which is a little annoying. I can understand that, like why you have to pay their costs and your resources. But, this is interesting. So, this guy... repairs instantly at the end of battle. That's pretty cool. Long range, powerful beams, yeah. Ignores 30% of all beam damage taken. Well, it's not too amazing. Ignores 75% of beam damage, also not amazing. Plus 25% manufacturing to any planet that the ship is stationed at. Oh, this changes the game, actually. That's really cool. That is really cool. It's almost tempting to buy this guy. Like, that is just an awesome bonus. 25% more manufacturing. That is, like 2 free refineries at the moment. Plus 100% influence per turn any starbase the ship is stationed at. That's an okay bonus. Has the hit points of a medium ship. Farseeing scope ship. Extremely large sensor range. Plus 5 credits per turn to any planet the ship is stationed at. Plus 3 the area effect of a starbase. Well, this is really neat. I actually like this. And these are Tech 2, I would assume. Okay, so we have to reach a higher level of research before we can get access to these guys. This is really cool, though. Alright. Hold on to your nuts 2 seconds, Mr. Bizarre. Because, yeah. So it is essentially 2 factories. Like, not really with the adjacency bonus, but that's very strong, certainly. Alright. Whoa, that is a really good planet. And wouldn't you know, we just got an amazing little colony ship here. Well, that's jeepers. Things are happening. I think that's actually a better planet than our homeworld is. It is, well, debatable because the fact we have an aquatic planet. So we are eventually going to be able to make this a bigger than the class 10. But, wow, man, mercenary system, very cool. I like it. That's one thing I really appreciate and enjoy in Master Ryan. We didn't really talk about that because I was exhausted. Gee willikers, indeed. Because Master Ryan has leaders that you can hire. And you start seeing the same guys over and over. Now, they only appear once per game. But you do see a lot of the similar people as you play through many, many times. And eventually you're like, oh, wow, like, oh, I hate this guy. Or, oh, I really like that guy. And it's just cool. It's nice seeing them over. Now, this ship does have a bonus to it, that it can colonize aquatic, frozen, and desert extreme worlds, which is a tech you don't get until super late in the game. I believe it's engineering. Nope, it's colonization. So you don't get it until here. So we would need 12 techs researched first and then all the way over there. So that's kind of cool. Kind of cool that we could get that. It's like I might save him. Like, getting this planet now is good. But the potential for having another planet that we couldn't get until much later, hard to say. I think that'll probably be fine, though. Those planets don't tend to be amazing, and we can already colonize aquatic ones. So let's just go for this Glycia. Glycia, too? Ew. This will be the... well, let's do the Mr. Rullet's Derp system. It's a reference to some stuff. Smart plants. There's a substantial evidence that much of the plant life on this planet is communicating with each other via pheromones, and that many may, in fact, be sentient. Unfortunately for us, the most intelligent plants seem to prefer the most fertile ground, which we earmark for farming. So we can lower our food production, but increase research, or... let me look at this thing. If the soil's good for the plants, it's good for us. Rip them out by the roots or burn them if needed. Let's see if they're smart enough to stop that. Oh, malevolent! You talk straight to my heart. Prometheus Stone. Caverns. Oh, this is the planet that we break the game on. That's excellent. I like that. Okay. Plus 2 to approval. Our intimidation center. Bada boom. Okay. Well, this is going to be it, boys. We're going to have to ignore, unfortunately, these military bonuses. That's okay. Like, it's not the end of the world. And again, this planet isn't super amazing now, but it will be in time. We're going to rush by. Always rush by your first factory. It really helps. You can rush by 2 if you're, you know, crazy. So because of that, we need to make this a production-heavy planet. That is definitely something we're going to have to do. But, wow, yeah, okay, I like it. I'm very happy about that. Already 3 planets, like, Jeebs. Oh, it didn't rename it. That's a little bit buggy. There we go, Mr. Relic's Derb. Okay, so you don't know where to go yet. We have one going that way, one going that way. Let's get one going over here. And hopefully we can snatch as much land as possible for the AI to realize that we're being cheeky. So 10 turns for a colony ship. We don't actually need a colony ship right now. I wouldn't mind getting a constructor going, actually. Speaking of, how is the homeworld doing? Working on our learning centers before basic factories. That was a bit of a misclick on my part. Let's rush by one of them. Sure you do. Thanks, Belle. Yeah, nice thing. This is okay planet. I mean, class 5 obviously sucks. We know that. But we're going to be able to make it better with our racial bonus. Like, eventually it'll be a class 8 by the end of the game. And then, of course, the bonuses you get from soil enrichment and yada yada hooser. But, it's okay. Got some nice bonuses. But nobody can colonize aquatic at the start of the game except for us, so we don't have to worry about it. Yes, you can, Nilokin. Yep, you could do that. I'm going to cure you of cancer and then enslave you in my sweatshop. Yeah, the nice thing, in Gal Civ 2, you just picked whichever you felt, like, whichever option gave you the better bonuses. And this is one thing I really like, because in Gal Civ 3, it's, you can pick whatever you want, but end of the day, you're also earning points towards one of the trees. So how it works right now is, as you spend more points in a tree, it becomes more and more expensive. So it now costs us 20 when the first one is 10. However, if I try and buy Benevolent, it's only 15. So, you know, it's slightly cheaper to buy something from a different tree. So you're almost rewarded in going between two. The only downside to going between two is, you know, of course, it takes longer to get to the higher end ones. But yeah, you could totally do that. Right now, we're just doing sort of one at a time type of thing. Certainly a lot to be said for going... grab the space junk, why not? A lot to be said for going for one and then getting a little bit out of the other one, but we're not doing that right now, so... I certainly wouldn't mind, like, early on that three... Why does it say two on it? Are you trying to sell me something? This is two. I don't know why. Maybe I can afford two of them or something? 28 treasury. Nice. Okay, a lot of Durantium down here. Thankfully, these are pirates. And not another civilization. Yeah, I assume it's just you can get two ships. So does it say pirate base? Yeah. It's kind of like a slightly modified Iconian thing. Alright, well, apparently we researched interstellar travel. Why did we research interstellar travel when I was one turn on this? I must have opened this at some point and accidentally clicked it. Probably when we were looking at, I have no idea. That is really weird to me. Oh well, I mean, interstellar travel is okay. It does get us plus one movement. But aside from that, kind of a waste. But oh well. And who are you? Okay, that is a pirate ship, that's fine. Fine with more pirate ships. Anyone? Okay, we got another colonizable planet. Ghost World, class 11. That's nice. An abandoned world filled with strange artifacts? Strange new artifacts to study. Gonna want to colonize that as well. Man, video games, stop giving me, It's Stop giving me planets. It's really nice. Okay, cool. We got that going. We want to get our planetary settlement. That'll be fine. Man. This is actually a very strong start. I can't argue with it. Sure, we didn't find a ton. Oh my gosh, another one. Oh no. Versus Torian Tipot. Oh shit. Well, we're next to these assholes. We already know what they get up to. Grab all the planets. Yeah, I mean, that's definitely something you want to do. Social manufacturing, bless food. That's okay. Like. So, the question is, do we go for the really ballsy rush by colony ships thing? Like, we certainly could. I don't know if it's the right idea. Because we need a lot of things right now. We need like 100 constructors. Getting the colonies early is nice. Oh, shit. We also have... Oh, it's a minor race. Oh, okay. Well, that's the Snathi who haven't... Oh, he stole the Ghost World. Well, they're apparently here somewhere. He didn't steal it, I guess, so much as... You know. Well, we're going to be killing ourselves soon. That's fun. Alright. Let's do it. I didn't want to, but... Oh! Oh, hey, that's the minor race of Snathi! I actually had a heart attack. I was like, oh gosh, not the other Snathi, but no, no. That's just the minor race version. It's fine. Yeah, I don't like the fact that we're so close to a horrible militaristic race. I've seen these Snaggly in action. I know what they're capable of. Or the Snathi Canadian? No, the Snaggly are. The Snathi are the most evil race left in the universe after the Dreadlords died. They were this sort of genetic freak creation that the Dreadlords created. And the Snaggly are the corporate offshoot of the Snathi. You know, they opened a wonderful theme park, and you can check that out. And actually, the last playthrough we did, the VODs should be on Twitch, but they're on YouTube, if not. It was pretty interesting. We went for a culture victory with one of the most evil races out there. So, unfortunately, guys, I'm looking somewhere around planetary invasion. That seems like that's going to be something we're going for. To that end, orbital manufacturing is going to be nice. We need to get our military up so we don't get pushed around. Universal translator we need right now, actually, because I need to be able to talk to these guys. I need Xenocommerce up and running, because we need more money than we currently have. Cool, another minor race. Wow, they actually have their home planet up here. Shit, that's annoying. So they're going to get that Promethean, which is okay. We do need to secure all the Durantium, though, so we have actual gun. That'd be good. Okay, there's another minor race. Minor races are kind of nice when you're militaristic, but kind of not, because they start with a lot of bonuses to everything. And a lot of ships... Oh, frick! And the Drengen are here? And that's a colony ship, isn't it? That's a colony ship. Alright, well, change-o plans. Was there something colonizable down here? No, just that one in the Ghost World. Yeah, alright, this constructor, we need you... I really want all this Durantium. We need that really bad. I'm not sure I can get all three. There's a pirate base nearby, which is annoying. We might have to risk it. Wow. Okay. Well, we don't need any more spawners for now. Let's get some hermit crabs going. Durantium. Nice. Oh, boy. Of course, we're next to the Drengen, though. The most evil race ever. Also, our nemesis. So there's got to be a planet they can colonize right here. They just did. That's a pretty good planet, too. Huh. Alright. Well, this is going to be interesting. I'm not sure our course of action. It might be some crazy rush, and I'm not very good at rushing in Gelsiv, as much as I would like to be. Okay, you're on auto-survey now. You've explored all the things. You are just on auto-explore. And we just need to check out a couple more solar systems real quick. Could we shoot down the colony ship? Yeah, if we had like one more turn, we might have been able to. So I need all of this. I need thulium, not so much. I really need this durantium as well, though. And they have another colony here, it looks like now, which is excellent. Really? They have another? They must just have a star base or something. Wow. Alright, this will be Nelakin. Thunderstorms. Wow, alright. So we can get research. Or we can get super research. Anyway, this planet is going through a period of heavy thunderstorm activity. This is affecting some ancient ruins near your colony, energizing what was thought to be inert stone, revealing it to be a powerful alien artifact capable of channeling tremendous energy. Sometimes the energy is channeled in the bodies of anyone standing nearby, with predictably messy consequences. Studying these ruins could prove incredibly valuable, while this is dangerous to anyone who has to do it. What are your orders? They knew what they were getting into when they were born in this society. Send the science nerds in. Give them gloves or something. Well, this is science world, and perfect, we have a massive approval bonus. So, we're not going to have to worry about approval, thankfully, on this. Alright, so we do want this to be super amazing, awesome research. So we'll get some good research going here. Unfortunately, we do need factories to start off, though. So that'll be okay. Probably do it about this way here. Alright, how is the homeworld, by the way? Well, this isn't the homeworld. Our ultimate goal is to conquer the galaxy. When we ultimately consume you, we want to know it wasn't personal. I mean, you've already literally been eating my race for, like, a period of time, and I don't like it. I think if we get here, I don't think we can get all three of them at once as much as I'd like to. Well, we can find out the easy way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's a no. Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we're not going to be able to get all of them. So we'll go here, grab 2, and then we'll get this one later. So relentless. Free production to our homeworld. Hard to argue with that. Doubles military production of our homeworld. Less building of death furnaces. All colonies receive a production bonus. Or go for money. I mean, this is pretty powerful here. Like, I don't know. This is pretty tough, right? So uncharitable. Like, I think the greed tree is going to be good. Obviously, motivation is going to be quite powerful. Free production to our homeworld. I feel like that's just a flat extra production right now. Double the military production is going to be so good, though. But then improving the class of our first 5 worlds by 1, can't argue with that either. Money does sound pretty good. It is only 10%, though. But the Citadel of Revenue, I mean. I think we're going to head this way to Ruthless. Just because I really want to get the, I really want to get a ton of military coming out. Okay, Xenocommerce. Yeah, we need money. That's a problem right now. Okay, you're working on that. Home planet, Toria. It seems for some reason it doesn't actually rename these properly. I don't know why that is. Because this was Nalakan over here. And this was our good friend Metalliturtle. Yeah, so I need those Durantiums for a war. I want that Durantium super bad. Man, this is a, okay. This start went from like amazing to like, oh, that's why. Like, this is a pretty large galaxy and we're super sandwiched in, actually, all things considered. You renamed the star? Nope, didn't do that. That would have been odd, though, if that was a thing you could do. Okay, let's rush that. Again, our money's getting a little low. Something we gotta worry about, but it's okay. Okay, so how are these coming? Aquatic biospheres. Cool. We want a hydroponic farm right here. Okay, cool. I've got some extra research. It's gonna help. Not a ton right now, but it will help. Alright, so we got that. Trading, blobby blue. I mean, we're... Wow, wealthy population, though. We're probably gonna have to go for supportive at some point. Orbital manufacturing, we need to start heading down the hole. Better frigates and stuff like that for the war stuff. And then we have to start heading down here for planetary invasion, which unfortunately takes a while to get to. Weapon systems are going to be good too, but yeah, definitely orbital manufacturing. Get that out of the way. Speaking of, we can talk to a lot of people now. Let's trade, shall we? Do you have any techs? Manufacturing specialization, I like it. I like it a lot. I don't have any techs you don't have. I'll trade you one of my Promethean stones, though. And money. Thank you. That is awesome. Alright, let's start talking to everybody else. Okay, you don't have any things. Dringin. Weapon system, supportive population. Right on. We'll trade you for that later. You know, I don't need this other Promethea stone right now. 590, that's a little expensive. I will give you one of my shitty scout ships. I don't want that. What about open borders, eh? Oh, you don't care about open borders, do you? Okay, how about this? You value supportive population less. Interesting. I don't need the morale right now, though. But guns, I like. We'll talk later. Alright, we'll talk later. What do you got for me? Oh my gosh, how do you have so many techs already? Like, why, though? Freaking these guys. Oh, jeez. Alright. What about Prometheus Stone? 590 for that.
Yeah.
Alright. How much money are you willing to give me for a tech? I don't have any tech. And you don't care about open borders. Actually, maybe my guys do care about open borders, though. Do you? Is that a thing? You guys care about open borders much? Nope, not at all. Alright. Well, the thing is, they don't have amphibious construction, but they have the equivalent that they have, and we just adapt it type of deal. Yeah. So some money, that's nice. Makes me more tempted to trade for guns. Yeah. I don't think there's any way I can get all these. No, not happening. Oh well, that's okay. Let's get Starbase going. Of course, we need the mining ring. Starbase defense system. Oh, we got some really cool looking starbases, that's for sure. So how long? One more turn on a hermit crab. I like it, because we need it up here. Right now. Okay, first Durantium mine. Cool. Actually, right here, I think... Wow, really? They have another planet? Maybe that's... That can't be their capital. Is this their capital? I don't know what their capital is. I'll be honest. I can't believe there's a planet right there, though. It's frustrating. Of course, it was a really good one. That's alright. But yeah, we're going to want to take this one and then that one there. We definitely don't need any more colony ships. That's not happening. We need to get a ton of constructors out and running and doing all sorts of things. And we'll figure things out from there. Intimidation's 105 turns here. That'll be nice. Increase the morale a little bit. We've got pretty crappy morale across the board. Meh. We'll deal with it later. Wow, no, yeah, they actually do just have... This has to be their capital right here. Which, they spawn, like, super close to me, if so. And if not, holy crap, they're crazy hacks. I don't even know. Yeah, just auto-explore. Okay. Nice. 100 bucks, I'll take it. Oh, good night, Metallic Turtle. So what do you want? You're asking for 24 credits a day. What are you joking, son? First off, the game goes in weeks, so I don't really know how that would work. Oh, shit. No way, they have another colony ship? There's no planets out there, dude. Oh, maybe there is. Fuck. No way. I don't have any guns on that ship. I'm really sad about that, if there is. Alright, well, it looks like I gotta kill the Snaggly first. Because apparently... That is an AI thing, though, knowing where all the things are at the start of the game. It's frustrating, but, could be a planet, like, right here. The odds of me not finding that are really low, though. But, anything's possible. Okay, nice. So, another basic factory going on. So, how are we punching out these now? Okay. Better. Like, no way he's just scouting with a colony ship, right? Like, he wouldn't. Shouldn't even plan after me so we can negative production and income. We got Mr. Relit's dirt, but yeah. Absolutely borrowed. Alright. Our shipyard's actually... Oh my goodness, you know what I did, guys? I messed up. We could have been doing this so much faster. That's frustrating. I forgot to edit the sponsors. Oh well. It's not like end of the world, but... Yeah, I need this one tile over to get that thulium. Oh, there's Durantium there, actually. Yeah, there totally was a planet there. Wow! Frick, really? Can I get this and the thulium? Yeah, I can. Nice. Oh shit. Is that in... Oh, Metallic Turtle's right outside! I ballsed it up! Oh well. I mean, I'm just using this for mining anyway, so it's not the end of the world. Oh yeah, there's gonna be Squirrel War. Oh my goodness! Don't really want to be fighting those guys either, because they're terrifying. Oh well, we'll see what happens to the Yore. So, what is this shit? Oh, a colony ship. Are there any colonies? Oh yeah, I guess there's this one right here. Sure. This will be borrowed. Little shit planet. Interesting. We didn't have a event pop up. So, yeah, they're just going to make this factories. And that'll be a pretty good factory spot there. And also, we should be able to build our... Interesting. Not letting me build the aquatic bonus. Oh well. Okay, pearls automatically in there. Well, this is... Yeah, I didn't want spawners. Shit, I wanted hermit crabs. I'm sorry, game. I know. Like, we'll keep this one, probably. No, I'm gonna cancel it, sadly. A lot of these, we need to start producing military ASAP. Wow. Alright. Orbital manufacturing is soon. That's good. Unfortunately, we can't do planetary invasion for a long time, so there's not really much point in going to war. Well, yeah, just quick battle, I guess. Pirates right there, that's interesting. Toxic world, that's actually quite a nice toxic world. But again, we can't use it until much later. Man, so much Durantium that we don't have yet that I need. We need that one, we need this one, and that one. Like, if we get this all, we're gonna have, like, at least decent trade offer. One Durantium for a supported population. This isn't the bonus I wanted, Yor. I really want that 10% extra thingy-doos. But making the Yor like me could be cool. Well, they have 5 planets. Really? Looks like everyone just spawned with a shitload of everything. Alright. Sure, you may have your one Durantium. Again, it's not the tech bonus I wanted, but... we might be able to trade for it later. So we got our orbital manufacturing... It's pretty useful. So what are you upset about? You have a ship in your zone of control and you want to conquer the galaxy. So... Apparently you're out researching me even though I have high out research. That's sad days. I mean, we are on a manufacturing focus, but still... what do we want right now? I guess... No, not that. Durantium refinery would be pretty good. Just 4 raw production. That's actually not insane at the moment. Oh boy. Alright. None of this stuff, really. I mean, another hydroponic farm would probably be a solid pickup. Let's get our population going crazy. More manufacturing. I kind of like the sound of that. I guess we worry about research right now. Seems like a solid bet. Alright. Get more production going. Cool. Orbital manufacturing, orbital specialization. Capacity is awesome. I'm tempted to take more military things though, but yeah, the capacity is really good. Either way, that's not where we go, because we're already at 80 to 12, and we need to start heading our way to planetary invasion. I need that ASAP. Defensive preparation. Not very good stuff, but none of this is really that good. But oh well. Gotta get it done. So, not Pearl. Yeah, see, again, it didn't rename that. I feel like that's really bugged, actually. It's the borrowed system. Was it Nalakin? No. Somebody here had... Yeah. Market centers. Market center. Population is currently maxed. So we're going to need somewhere for... Population, maybe here. It's probably okay. Yeah, this is going to be a production-heavy world for sure. That'll be good. We're going to need that one. So might as well get it now. And what do you get? A bonus approval. Yeah, we already got that approval there. So I think we're okay. We don't need any more approval. Probably just... was this the one that gets a lot of bonus research? Yeah. So we're going to just get more research going on. And a planetary soil upgrade right here would be nice. That's true, yeah. Not everyone is horribly dying. You got that right, friend. Alright, tempted to take this off. Not the end of the world, and it helps my research and net income a ton, which is cool. I mean, it does lower the production of hermit crabs, which I super need. That's not currently being mined. I think we steal that while we can. I need that one, I need this one, and I want this one over here. Yeah, if I can snag that, that'd be awesome. Okay, at least we're starting to get some income. Yeah, right now it's not being mined, which is cool. So. It is really tempting. Okay, we get mining barracks now, which is nice. Unfortunately, we're not at the point where we can just ship those out yet. Mysterious hardware. Cool, we got some more tech coming on our way. Yeah, I know, you're really pissed about things and stuff. Okay, enhanced training, we need to get our soldiering up, which would be good. We have an idle colony. Tori has finally finished building things, except for that one. So, not really. Not quite there yet. And then military subsidies. Alright. Got another mining base. So right there. There's definitely something to be said for building culture star bases right now and trying to flip some of this guy's shit. We're going to piss him off. Like, yeah, he's got so much, though. I think we just go for invasion on him. I think that's going to be our big win. Alright. I want this one as well. So... Well, no way! The Snaggly... Oh, they got to just have a star base here. There's no way they have... A planet right here, too. Frickin' Snaggly. Bannable. Absolutely bannable. Alright. Let's see, how long we got? 8 turns, all that cool stuff. Yay, money! Oh boy. We're also gonna want a shipyard. Maybe over in the lock-in way. It's actually not too crazy. It's not really producing enough to worry about that, so... Oh well. We'll want to move our shipyard here at some point, but... For now, it's okay. We might not get an opportunity. Awesome. Enhanced training's done. Planetary invasion. Okay, so we are two techs away from being able to get planetary invasion. That is cool. Unbroken Spirit. Oh, nice. That's a racial thing for the Torians. Huh. Well, we need military. Unbroken Spirit's actually quite tempting for that bonus HP. We can get engineering way or colonization. I need industry stuff. Mega factories. Just a flat bonus to research over here. Yeah. Yeah. Some pretty good stuff. Weapon systems, we need that as well. I think we go weapon systems and unbroken spirit and see what happens. Unless there's any chance that we can grab the next level ship. No, that is way off. Yeah, unfortunately. Alright. Well, let's get weapon systems going then. And then we can at least start prototyping a ship. Our own creation is turning against us. Oh, hell yeah, they are. Like, they're everywhere! Okay, yeah, stay out of the Dringan's territory. That'd be cool. That causes us to have massive diplomatic issues with them. The Yor kind of like me, though. Alright, hang on. Is there anyone I can trade with? Accelerate growth. Not amazing. It really isn't. It's kind of turd. Amphibious construction. Yes! I will teach you about militarization. And pay you... Wow, really? You think it's that good? I don't know, pal. I'm not sure it is. I will give you a thulium. I'm not going to be using it. And yeah, that's fine. Alright. Hey, friends. You have a lot of shit. Wow, you have so much shit, though. That's insane. I would love optimized stuff. Yeah. I'll teach you about militarization. Pay you a little bit of money. No, of course you want a lot, don't you? Well, I can actually trade them Durantium, because we'll get it back when we declare war on them. But I'm not sure I want to give that to them. Sure. Trade you a ship range and a stone. That makes you move a little faster. That's pretty good for us, honestly. Wow, they have a ton of money. Wow, they've got a good amount of ships. Are they mostly beam ships? Yeah, beam with missile defense. That's going to work for me. Alright. Ah! Guys! Kluntzville exists! They have another colony that's out there. We can't even see it. Holy crap. Actually, my mind right now, I can't. I don't, and I won't. Why do they have so much stuff? Oh my goodness. Maybe custom races are, like, hella OP. I don't know. Anyway, yeah, there will be good. Can we build it here? Might as well, actually. That'll help. And we need one down here. So it's coming. Two turns, not too bad. Clinting its way through the universe. Yeah, I might not be able to win this game, actually. As much as I want to, we could hire a mercenary. Has the hit points of a medium ship. Like, that's not amazing, though. That's just not that good. Notice 30% of all beam damage taken. I mean, that's interesting. We need Illyrium, and we haven't found any yet. Yeah. Interesting stuff, though. Alright, we need one. And we can probably get that Durantium after. So I really want one here. Okay. Then five tiles of the starbase. Yeah, there's one there, so. We can build it here, yeah. Hopefully it'll let me build it right here. I might have ballsed myself up. You want militarization? No, I don't think so, Tim. So we can get it right here, yeah. So that'll cover three of our planes. We're going to make this an economic ring. And then we're going to get starbase factories and 0G scaling and more research. Morale, we're not going to worry about right now. Income, absolutely. These are all things we need. Okay, cool. We have that now. Unbroken Spirit. No, we can get Planetary Invasion right now. That's excellent. Let's get Unbroken Spirit, though. It's four turns, and we're producing a lot of ship-based stuff, like constructors and things like that. Yeah, so he doesn't actually have a lot of military right now, which is pretty cool. Alright. So you, we need this Durantium one here. No way! He's got another freaking colony ship. Where's it going? What else is there to colonize? I think we almost might be better off taking out the Drangan at this point. As crazy as that sounds. But, like, I need him out of the game. Like, the Drangan are always going to be a pain, unfortunately, but... Okay... I might as well move this as much as we can first. It's fine. Okay. This poor little starbase, hang in there. Holy crap, you guys are terrifying. What do you have, by the way, tech-wise? I need tech. Real bad. You don't have anything. Shit, you don't have anything. That's kind of sad. We're friends, man. Accelerate growth. Why you gotta do this to me? Drangan. Militarization for... No. Nope. Defense systems? Yeah, maybe targeting specialization, actually, in a few turns. Good sir, your mouth is an anus and you have two drills coming out of it. Seek help. Totally. Totally. So we're going to go ahead and specialize our weapons to do reduced mass. And then in five turns, we'll trade the Drangan for the targeting specialization for more accuracy. Which I think will work out for me. So we'll have both of them. It'll be quite good. Man, these guys, though. Alright. Yep. Let's get a... So, we have a Starbeach. I think we can get one here. Yep. So, this is going to be a culture one. Absolutely. Just try and fight back against it. It's not going to work too well for us, but we're doing our best. Oh, man. Things are scary right now. Home planet has a lot of manufacturing, which is cool. How are other planets coming? Slowly getting there. Population's maxed right now. Shit. Advanced aquatic biospheres. 36. Oh, wow. Okay, we need to cancel that planetary soil upgrade. And put this here to make the planet slightly not garbage. Yeah, population. It's mostly this population that's killing me right now. So... It's alright. A few mistakes were made, but not the end of the world. Galactic event. Wow, extra influence to all colonies, approval all colonies. Of course, we do have to go for 30 malevolent. You have work in the morning? I'm sorry to hear that. Yeah, I'm trying to lock in. I'm trying. I appreciate that, man. I gotta start heading to bed myself. So, doubles the military production of our homeworld, though. Absolutely, yeah, not even a question. Now we're talking. Now we can pump these guys out. The lobster. Wow, they knew. But So one more turn, we get our military specialization, or miniaturization specialization. Then we can trade with the Drengen, and we'll see how things go from there. So hey, Mr. Drengen, let us be a little bit of friends. How do you have so much more tech than me, though? Fuck. Alright. Not the end of the world. Yeah, I'll give you that militarization you really wanted. And, wow, really interesting. I'll also give you this. No. Fine, then. Teach me about, defense systems would be cool. Yeah, I'll buy that off you. Yeah, I thought you were saying to me, I was like, oh, man. So, Starbase Market coming our way. Alright, what are we researching? Planetary invasion, that's not a question. Oops, not that. Planetary invasion, cool. We need to take a snaggly out of the game. Like right now, they're absolutely ridiculous. Starbase is really hard to kill right now, which is something that we can use to our advantage. Because they can't really retaliate aside from bombing our planet, and they don't have planetary invasion. We have planetary invasion. So, that's a good thing. Let's go ahead and design our first ship then. The ship that is going to take us to victory. New design. Oh, we can get a small one. That looks quite nice. This is pretty fun. Oh, I like... Ooh. Ooh, a little bard. I like this. Okay, we're just going to use the hyperdrive plus. I could probably get away with just the regular hyperdrive, actually. It's not that much more. Yeah, let's just put the larger mass on there. We do need to have some moves. Alright. A Durantium driver. Yeah, just a massive one right on top. It's maybe a little too big. Alright, we could actually go two of them, maybe. Yeah, I think we'd probably fit two on each. So we'll put on the wings, then. 420 blaze it, dude, absolutely. Alright, looking good there. So we can build four of these, then. 16 is pretty strong. And we just need some deflectors. That spot looks pretty cool. I mean, this is a ship. Is it a ship that wins us the game? I don't know, but we'll try. We got 10 more, really. That's 7.2. I wish we had... We just put some crappy lasers on there. It's almost tempting to do that, just put crappy lasers. Because their mass is 9. I mean, it's only 2. It's probably not even going to get through their shields at that point, actually. Maybe we go for thrusters? Better acceleration, tactical speed. Or maybe we just kind of keep it cheap. I mean, it's already 255. What is that going to make it? 7 more. That's not the end of the world. Well, I was kind of hoping that was going to mirror. Mirror, mirror, mirror. It's one of these things here. No? It's alright. Made a Spitfire? Yeah, something like that, actually. Right, yeah, that'll do. Yeah, it looks pretty cool. Alright, we'll save this. This will be the... Well, not the lobster, actually. This will be our paper crane. Well, I suppose, actually, we're aquatic, so the paper crab. And we're gonna need a lot of those. How much for the paper crab? 3 turns! Not bad, actually. We can get 4 of those, so... that will almost get us to planetary invasion, which is perfect. That's exactly what we want. So this is their big ship, huh? 18 credit. Who are you? Who are you to ask me for this crazy crap? Damn insane, that's what you are. Okay, advanced aquatic biospheres we need on this planet. The population's gonna max soon, unfortunately, so I have to build it here. Yeah. Not amazing. Is it still 3 turns? Yeah, that's good. More like paper crap. Thanks, man. I appreciate that. Makes me feel really good. Oh, we can definitely... So we'll go for that one first. Do we even know where... Clintopolis is? Oh my god, they have so much, though. No, we don't know where it is. Alright. Just meet up here. So we're going to start losing income soon, which is all right. Oh, you're pop capped. I completely forgot about that. That's awkward. Yeah, production here is not super cool. Let's buy this hydroponic farm. It's going to help everything. Do we ever get this built yet? No. Because it's way down here. There you go. Production. Wrong thing. Get working on that. Tile turtle. Nice. So you need to get your hydroponic farm, and that needs to be the most important thing you do. Well, except for this market center. That's alright. Good. Bottom right, a solar planet. Yeah, I know. They have one here somewhere. I don't know what it is, but... It's kind of crazy. These are snaggly, right? Yeah. Like, it's just terrifying. They're actually everywhere. And their culture is insane, and... Everything's nuts, dude. Everything's nuts. Oh, we're not going to be able to take out one of the larger races. Well, like, the miners start with, like, a huge amount of... Actually... We can take these guys out. Alright, that'll be our leapfrog into it. I like that. The Yor are right here. Can we ally with the Yor? Well, no, not forever, actually. That's not going to be able to happen. I want to be friends with you, though. We'll talk. Open borders? Pay me 94 bucks for it. Get out of my life. These damn squirrels, they make everything nuts. You're going to love my nuts. Yeah, all right. Let's get going with these. I mean, we could try and take out the minor races and get these super planets. It's not impossible, it's improbable, but not impossible. Gift of... No, sorry, I can't give you defense systems. I'm not insane, dude. I would like to be, but... Alright, speaking of... We can now start worrying about getting more Durantium. So that is 2 Durantium. So that's another paper crap. That's 2. That's another paper crap. Yeah, that'll be good. Nice. Planetary invasion in 4 turns. Not too bad. Crap, man, we're producing these really fast, actually. Probably just banking up a ton of production, that's why. I would love to get a military starbase somewhere in the middle. Whew, I don't know, though. We'll see what happens. Planetary invasion in 2 turns. No, I'm not going to give you money. Do I look like I'm doing well? I don't, do I? Maybe I do. Alright, let's get these going. Holy shit! Huge ass bug. Too spooky. I don't even know what kind of bug that is. My life right now. I could probably tell if I had light, but I don't. Eh, it's flying again. Fucker. Well, there we go, guys. It's GG. It's rip. I can't. I thought I was going to lose the squirrels, but I'm losing the bugs. Who knew? It's over. Alright, so we're going to need one over by Nalakin. And one over by Mr. Rollitz Derp. Cool, we got our planetary invasion. Invasion optimization. Yeah, I would love to learn about biological warfare. That would be great. That would be super cool, actually. Alright, so we're losing a little bit of cash. Not ideal. But it's alright in the day. Metalliturtle. Yeah, we'll do it that way. That'll be a little bit more cash coming our way. So, designer. Let's look at our... The title? Is this the invasion one? Yeah. So use this design. What do you got on you? 2 hyperdrive plus. Increased ship range. We don't really need that right now. Allows it to invade planets. I mean, yeah. Don't need sensors at all. That is going to make it a little cheaper. I think we'll save that. That'll be fine. Title M2. Yeah, that's right, man. I don't negotiate with terrorists. Where's the title M2? There she is. Oh, it's one for either or. Maintenance 0.5 versus 1.3. Well! That's that, then. We're already broke, so... Yep. 3 of those will be enough. So we can take this guy out now, yeah. Totally. Oh, yeah. It costs population. I forgot about that. That's alright. I probably don't even need 3 of them. To be honest. But oh well, that's okay. So this is now a fleet. And we can actually only have 3 of them in a fleet at one time because of our logistics. So we can actually put this guy back at the home planet. Yep. It's 2 transports. Again, we're lowering our production and everything by doing this, but... Holy shit, huge pirate fleet. Not ideal. Actually, why don't you... You meet up with them and you blow up that pirate fleet of 5 things. Let's check out our ship, shall we? Interesting they were able to hit me with beam weapons from across the map. Oh, you're gonna come back? Wow, they just took off. What is going on there? Whatever. So yeah, we're doing pretty good. Decent ship. Okay, you head back and repair, you head here. How are ideologies? We do have points coming in now, which is a bonus. People probably don't have that happening. Alright. And this transport, we are going to have just guard here. Yeah, so our income penalties kind of suck. But that'll be alright. A couple more turns, we'll take this guy out. We might be able to take out Snathy. Oh, 13 ships defending, jeez. Drangin wanted open borders with me. Yeah. Sure, I'm willing to do that, actually. How much you pay me? 6. Sure. You have some really nice stuff, and I have some really expensive stuff. We'll talk later. They're gonna like me more now. Yeah, it's pretty good actually. Let's get the Yor having open borders with us too. Let's really have them like me. Oh, you guys are actually broke as shit. I mean, I will take that money. It's not a lot of money, but... I don't want accelerated growth. I guess we take it anyway. Trading militarization for it. Sure. It's fine. Alright, we got a hermit crab here. Let's get a star base going. This will be an economic ring. Yeah, we got this stuff going. That'll be fine. We don't need the recreation center. Not yet, anyway. So, you I just want. No, not the title. There we go. Hermit crab. Where's Mr. Rillet's derp? Okay, they're up to 5 ships defending now. Getting a little scary, but we can still take them. We'll go for it next turn. Oh, fuck off. That's outside my range. Really, though? That's awkward. The one time ship range was actually semi-important. That is really awkward. Fuck. I can't believe that. Alright, well, let's get this ship over. That's gonna take 10,000 years. Oh, I ballsed up, guys. I need a title mark 2. No, not a title mark 2. Where's the hermit crab? Why is it not in the favored ships anymore? It's random. I don't know. Fucking this. Oh my god. It's like I keep thinking it's like gone, but it keeps coming back, this bug. Like, why do they do this, man? I don't get it. How long do you get over here? 6 turns? Yeah, alright. Be right back, everybody. Well, it's gone, so, I mean, I'm not going to be able to sleep tonight. That's excellent. Oh, well. Yeah, hemorrhaging a little bit of money. 2 ships defending. 1 ship defending. The fact the AI don't pay maintenance is starting to become an issue for us. But it's not the end of the world. I don't think we're going to need both these, but we have it just in case. That is so frustrating, though. We just need to extend that, like, just slightly. Where's the other one I sent out? Oh, there it is. Piece of shit. Yeah, it's a really huge bug, and I don't recognize it right away. Kind of look like a... I don't know. Okay, so where's the hermit crab that I just built? That we sent here. Is that this one? No, it's not, but that'll do. Right there, that's not too bad. We'll figure out where the other one went. I don't know what happened to my survey ship. I guess it's just gone. Which is unfortunate. I can't believe the Snaggly just took over everything. So fast. That was my survey ship. Oh, there it is. 4 turns versus 3 turns. We'll go with the 3 turn one. You can come back down and do what I was having him do originally. Okay. Biological warfare, excellent. What could we use right now? No, not really. More fleet logistics is cool. Military manufacturing, solid. I mean, storage maximization is going to be what we ultimately get, I think. 5 logistics is another ship in the fleet, though. Yeah, I hate that, but that is the one I have to take. I really... Well, now they have 11 ships defending. Bloodlust, plus 20% soldiering, minus 2 diplomacy, all races. Wow, that's interesting. Not ideal. So now the AI is just like shitting out ships, though. Like 11. That's Oh hey Kryn, what do you have? I need stuff, and I need to have a friend on the other side of the planet that I can trade stuff, so I don't care if they kill me. Wealthy population. I really wanted that. Militarization. I'll give you that. I'll give you miniaturization. And how many credits? 180. Done. Thank you. That money is going to help quite a bit. Alright. If I build a star base here, should extend our range just slightly. Well, maybe. Yeah, we'll wait. You're right. You're right, me. Just wait. Get that going, I guess. Mining barracks are cool. I already got that stuff going. Economic ring, yeah, I get this stuff going. Don't need a recreation center, we got tons of that. Ruffles Nagel, who are you? I'm you, but more overpowered. That's funny. How many ships do they have now? Still 11. So potentially conquerable. Okay, let's get our star base right here. Yay! They're immune to war for 28 more turns. Why that is, I don't know. But that kind of fucked me up. Alright, well I guess we go down here and look for that snaggly planet that we know exists. Well, that's interesting. Alright. So, let's get more paper crabs. Yeah, get all that stuff going. Like, there has to be one right here, somewhere. Yeah, no, we're not giving you tech for nothing. Let's kill these pirates. I don't want to waste health on these pirates, but I also don't want them blowing up my fleet. Like, what do they have here? I don't know, guys. Ah, there you go. Draken 1. Oh, that's a really good planet, actually. Hey, what's up? Oh, they don't even have... They don't have anything defending it, so that's awkward. Oh, they're sending a bunch of ironwoods in. Some hunters. Oh, yeah. Interesting. What's coming? Yeah, zero G gravity construction would be really cool. Sadly, we really need to get research going. Because we're hella behind. More growth is interesting. More food? Yeah. Let's get education going. Alright, let's cut off his fleet as he comes in. That's interesting. He's like, I'm coming to defend it. Yeah, have fun, pal. Time for peace. Oh, prepare for war. Oh, he literally just declared war on me. Alright. That costs money. We can't really afford that. But... cool. Well, that's my planet now, nerd. Thanks. Alright, what do you have here? Tons of frickin' money. Well, that's... a thing. I don't really know what you're doing here, pal. It's interesting. We'll see what happens, though. We'll see. What's that? Oh, they're blowing up one of my constructors. Standard. So, I could blow up... I should probably try and take out their ships while I can, actually. Let's see how we fare against an Ironwood. Oh, wow. Wreck, son. I didn't even take damage. That would be really funny, yeah. Nah, unfortunately you're right, bro. You can't do that. Victory uncertain. Oh, I don't like that. How long for my, yeah, paper crabs first would be okay. Alright, well, this fleet needs to get way to F up here. Four turns, alright. I'm sad about it, but I'm not gonna cry. I mean, even if we just get a single, hey, a culture relic. Would be nice to have noticed that earlier in the game, too. But well. Even if we just get one planet out of it, like, we're good. But they have so many colonies. Like, look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like, look at, like, this is RNG for you, though, right? Like, how many nice planets did they spawn by versus us, sandwiched in between two extremely aggressive races? But that's the way she goes, I guess. Alright, let's watch this. This is a missile ship. So he's using antimatter missiles, which we don't have access to. We did take some damage, but ultimately their fleet is nothing against us. So that's really good. Okay, we got another paper crab here. Let's go kill that one. Next paper crab should be next turn. Cool. So I think that was like their entire military we just killed. Yeah. Alright. So there's an Ironwood there. Beware, we've received reports of pirates. Yeah, there's pirates going around. That's a thing. Paper crab. Victory uncertain. So I'm not in love with that. I don't like the idea of uncertain. Victory likely. See, why are you victory likely and your victory uncertain? I don't know. Oh, because you can't attack this turn, maybe? Oh no, your victory likely now. Warp. I don't know. Either way, and then they got a hunter there. Okay. So I would really like more of these ships, but I can't build them. I need more Durantium. Which I should have soon, actually. Maybe. Maybe not. Our poor starbase, though. Oh well. Alright, this is gonna be a tough one. Nope, we won. Not too bad then. Oh, he's running. He's like, oh crap! Oh, okay. They don't have a factory here that I can see, but they're shitting out ships every turn. Probably because they're rich? Question mark? I don't know. Which of you is not damaged? Apparently the damaged one is victory certain. Yay, shields. Okay, well at least we can have four in a fleet now. We could actually have five. Which is fine, we got a paper crab right here. Yeah, let's join up. So two turns, we'll be able to attack. We can now start building death furnaces. I think we might go for the money, though. Well, death furnace sounds cool. I wonder what it does. I just gotta know, right? Death furnaces. Raw production, more merciless culture. Wow, raw production plus 50%. Whoa! That's pretty good. It's pretty good. Is there only one, maybe? One per player. So it would be solid on here, but ultimately I'm going to be putting it on... Not in Hillock, and I certainly wish I remembered to build the farm here 10,000 years ago when I said I was going to. Yeah, that'll help make Nalakan actually semi-decent. Same thing. I wish I remembered to do that. I wish they didn't just auto-queue up the upgrades and they built the useful stuff, but that's okay. Is it here? No? Ah, here it is, yeah. So on this planet, we could really use it. We don't have, like, room for it. That's sad. Maybe we just put it on our home planet, then. No, I would really like it here, so... We'll make it work. We'll figure something out. Yeah. Death furnace. We might be underwater, but we'll burn them anyways. I like it, Borg. Yeah, I think this guy is regretting declaring war on us now. I mean, sure, he's like rush buying ships every 2 seconds, and that's not cool, but end of the day, you know. Oh, really? I can blow these guys up with my survey ship? Get wrecked, son. Alright, cool. That is a planet ready for invasion. I should have... Yeah, there we go. Hopefully we don't get killed on the way there. Okay, I actually really need more Title Mark 2s. The Dragon owned 4 hexes in Snaggly space? What? Wait, what? No, I think that's supposed to be like there's nothing there, because that's a bug. If the Dragon randomly have that, there's just got to be like there's nothing there. Okay, you guard. Oh, they're panicking now, boys. Yep. Launch them all. Oh, the panic is real. I see that. Victory! Well, that's mine now. Let's watch this. This is going to be a big fight. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, his shields broke! The deflectors are offline! No! Porkins! I can handle it! Pull up! I got this! Oh, wow. You're wrecked. Alright. Wow, thank you, Fabre-Orlay. Here we go. Victory! This is why playing military can be pretty fun, and why most people do it. I don't, because I'm ultimately a nice guy. Do we blow up their shipyard, too? Yeah, probably, right? It'd be good if they didn't have a shipyard. We are going to take some hits here. Shipyards are nasty. Also, they had stuff inside their shipyard. Oh, that's so funny. The shipyard can't fire till we get close. That's really cool. So missiles would actually be better on a shipyard than anything else. Oh, they have an escort there. And another starbase. It's actually a decent ship that they're packing. So. Alright. Not the end of the world, though. We're going to head here next. We need, more paper crabs would be good. More everything would be good. That's alright. On our way. Cool, we've got more research going. Better farming and food and stuff would be excellent. Definitely feeling that right now. Fabriole. Café au lait, yes. Coffee of milk. Excellent. Well, it is actually a production planet. Shouldn't really be so surprised, I suppose. It's extremely randomly set up, though. But that's fine. What is this? Solar power plant. Yeah, I don't know why. I don't know. The AI does what the AI does. I'm really tempted. Yeah. I want to get desk furnaces on the home planet just because that production is really nice. But I want Nalak in the VR. Not Nalakin, sorry. I want Metalliturtle to be our... It's Rolladsterp, this place here. So things we need. We need a planetary defense. Oh, not there. Now that'll be... No, we need those for later. And we'll talk about that. We're going to abuse the military thing. So, idle colony. Yeah, you don't have anything to do. So actually... You know what? Working on a shipyard might not be a bad idea for this place. Because they can't really do anything useful right now. And having another shipyard would be cool. Put it in between these two. Yeah, load that transport ship. Get her going. So, yeah, this guy's running. Let's blow up his other super ship. Probably gonna lose one here. Did we? We did not. Alright, on our way to Raven Guard then. Oh, hello! Hello, little chap! It's like, seriously, please don't. I'm like, no. Alright. What are we blowing up here? A hunter versus a okay, well, they've killed my scout ship. That's moderately annoying. I don't know if I can take this guy out of the game, because he's got like 1,000 colonies. But... no, I'm not going to give you 150 credits. Sorry, Kryn. I like you, but I don't like you. If you get my drift. They're like, no, I don't know what you mean. What's up? It's like, well, I'm sorry. Oh shit, that's gonna be annoying. Movements too. Yeah, they can't get to me, thankfully. Alright, we're gonna need another title. Two more paper crabs. Hello, little sheep, I am here for your death. Yeah, they're in trouble. Yep, even more. I'm offloading the entire population of the homeworld because that's how we roll. Okay. Let's watch the battle for the homeworld. Well, it's not their homeworld, but... Well, they have a bigger ship now. Shit, that's actually a little scary. We haven't had a chance to repair, which is a little rough. Yep. Yep. Well, we got this place now. We don't have enough movement to shoot these guys, do we? Oh, we do. Alright. Hey, it's Cluntsville! They've only got 4 ships defending. We might be able to do this. The annoying thing, so we want to take Cluntsville for sure. I know it's tempting to go for their other 2 planets, which are solid. The reason why we're going for Cluntsville is the AI, like we've mentioned, does have this annoying little habit of just, hey, you know what would be cool if I just surrendered? No. That's not cool. And I'll have to just give up. But they don't surrender to you. They surrender to some random person. Because they hate you. So this planet is also quite interesting. They're going for tons of money. Like, just tons of money. Which, like, that's not a bad thing, right? But it is when you do it the way they're doing it. Like, money's fine, but you need to have population for that to work. You know? Like, we actually have to get rid of this for more farming. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. The Clintsville of 143 production? Yeah. I mean, our home planet is Toria, I believe. 200? Oh, it's only 101. Whoa! Clintsville! Please! Don't worry, we're going. We're gonna get right in there, boys. They're spamming ships into it, though. It's a little scary. So, it should be two turns we take it out. I might need two sets of stuff for it. Paper crab, get going! How's Toria doing? Nothing upgrade? Good. Oh, shit. Huge fight. Oh, they're actually chasing me down now, which is the scary part. So that's their entire army, except for five ships on Clintsville, which we can't take now. That's okay, it's not the end of the world. There's their shipyard. This little guy's kind of annoying. Sneak around the back, maybe. Do they have any ships here? One ship, if I'm wrong. I would love to be sneaky and go for them, but again, I don't have any guarantee. So we'll sneak around, see what happens. Like that is just a space asshole. That's what that is. Kind of odd. Okay, so we're just gonna park it here. It's fine. And it'll be four turns until I can get my crabs to the front line, sadly. Alright. Can I build any more? No. Is there anything we can build? Just little crappy ships. You know what? We'll make some dolphins. Why not? Fuck Uranus, we're going in hot. Absolutely. Let's start going for soil engineering. We haven't done a lot of trading this game, because we're kind of the bad guys. I don't know if you noticed. I mean, I could definitely take Servoro, but I want Clintsville. Oh god, seven ships defending now. Maybe we take this and we go for Clintsville in a later war? I don't know. No. No, that's right. We can't compromise at this point. The moment we compromise, we've already lost. We just need to sit here and repair without any ability to repair. Oh shit, they got a hunter coming for me. It's terrifying. Thankfully we got like insane movement. I don't think he can chase me down. Alright, yeah, so I guess you guys just, see, this place needs more population. But we don't have any way of doing that for five turns, so I guess just work on your economy would be cool. Like, we're operating at a fairly large money deficit. Meanwhile, the Drangan, everybody, they'll do that. Also, these guys that we were gonna totally kill, that we can't kill, which makes me sad. Yeah, they're a thing. Alright, let's get the dolphins up here. Nine turns, that's a little sad. Defeat near certain. Sadly, we also can't kill their shipyard. It's not gonna happen. Alright, maybe we just... Okay, let's just go over here. Pop this real quick. Because ultimately, they're going to be getting more production, or, like, production from here. So, shit, paper crab versus a hunter. Yeah, sure. In a heartbeat, man. No, I can't give you 150 credits. Sorry, I don't think you understand. I'm losing money myself. Okay, so we only need one of these two. Just want one of you. Nice. Do we go for you? Sure, we'll send these two down there. Homeworld, you can start producing another paper crab. Dolphin, yeah, get the dolphins up here. I mean, do we go for it? It's tough, right? Like, ultimately getting Clintsville is what we need to do to win. Not sure we can do it, though. Yeah. Let's go for it. Let's see if we can force them to surrender to me. Oh, they have nothing to say to me. They're pretty pissed. Well, we're going to save it up here. Torian 1. We'll just play for a little longer, and then we'll call it. So here was this colony. Just research. Losing a lot of money. Apparently, a foreign power has a lot of influence on here. Herpity deer. So I guess we just work on probably just building research here. That'll be fine. Alright, paper crab soon. There it is. So in 5 turns we might be able to take him out. Let's kill a burner while we can. As long as we can stop them from getting more than 7 ships, I mean, we got a chance. But, we'll see. Okay, good. That's gonna help. Extreme colonization. Yes, actually, there is a planet we could colonize with extreme colonization. That toxic one. Right here. Atmospheric cleansing we need for it, actually. Which is, yeah, all the way down there. So never mind, we're not going to be able to get that. Spawning pool enhancement, more growth. We really just need more research at this point. We're very much behind in that. Yeah. So more research, cheaper maintenance. Nah, just flat research bonus would be cool. Can't get any more paper cranes. Stingray. Costs thulium. It's a little stronger. Moves 3. Not really what I want. Probably just go for another dolphin. This actually isn't too bad. There's no attack on it, but... I mean, we don't really need the dolphins right now. But I'm going to build them anyway, because I'm crazy. But this is what I love about 4X game. Oh, shit. Faber-Orlais has been overrun by a strange alien norovirus. It rapidly kills about 5% of those it infects, but its curious side effects of making those who survive profoundly more intelligent. Oh. Our scientists found a means to cure it, but some wonder if we should consider allowing the disease to flourish to take advantage of the side effects. So, Benevolent gives us 10% research to affected planet. Whoa, pragmatic. 50% research to the planet, minus 20% growth on the planet, or never let a good norovirus go to waste. Immunize yourself and your friends, then spread the disease throughout your colonies. Plus 10% research, minus 10% growth, but to every colony ever. Yes. Yeah, I will take that in a heartbeat. That is amazing. How's our ideologies coming, by the way? Close to unforgiving. All colonies receive a 20% more raw production bonus. That is amazing, of course. Alright. Are these three healthy guys? Four healthy guys. Are we able to take out the star base yet? Because that's our issue right now. Our big issue is not being able to kill the star base. Okay, paper crab. Excellent. Everybody is going now, so that's good. Victory uncertain. Defeat is likely if we try and take on the planet. We may not have what it takes to crack this, sadly. Defeat is still likely if we go for everything, but victory is likely. Okay, so we can blow up the star, the shipyard now. At which point, we just need something that can crack a lot of ships. Now, the one answer to that is, of course, build a lot of more ships. And to that end, we might go ahead and edit the dolphin here. Yeah, these lasers are really shit. But sadly, we don't really have into that. We just need more Durantium. Alright, well, in that vein, that is good, actually. Why did I not queue that up? What happened there? I don't know. Do we have any of these that do not have mining put on? You need mining? You need mining. Soil engineering. Yep, that'd be good. Here's an okay. This planet's just built kind of dumb. I'm not a fan of what they're going with here. Yeah, we'll get more people on the planet. Soil engineering. Oh, yeah, we can soil engineering all our planets now, which is quite nice. Yeah, another farm would be good. So many just odd decisions by the AI. That's okay. Toria. So for this planet, getting more research is tempting, getting more production is really tempting. I think we go for more research, I think we're doing okay as is. Taloturtle. Money is good. More farms are great. Relisterp. Yeah, this is our most important one, actually. So we do need more food. Yeah, we definitely just need more population right now. Alright. Let's go here for that. Just want the wealth, that's fine. What do these things give? Plus 3 manufacturing. Actually, right there, I think that's what we do. I like it. Alright. I like it. Alright, dolphin. Yeah, everyone just head up there. So now we can blow up the shipyard. What? No, I'm not going to be enhanced training. Do they have anyone defending it right now? I don't think so. Oh, yeah, apparently they have a shitload. Alright. Blow them up! What are these? Plunderers? Nice. They're wrecked. Oh, shit, we're coming in hot! Nice. Alright, well, that lets me build a few more paper crabs. Money's good, production's better, but a super virus tops them both. Damn right. That's how it goes. So we'll guard here. I really am tempted to... Oh, wow, now we can produce two more of our ever-popular paper crabs. Man, we've been tanking money for a while. We had like 1,000 going into this war. But, ultimately, it's working out, right? Like, can't argue with the results, I believe is how that goes. So, we almost have enough stuff to just throw at the problem. It's gonna take, probably when he gets here, 5 turns. Not too bad. Optimized schooling, cool. Cities of learning, yeah, we just need research at this point. We actually need to start trading with people. Hey, Snathy. Xenobiology, I don't really care about that, actually. Interstellar trade is interesting, though. I'll give you militarization, wealthy population, and environmental engineering? Oh, you don't have any money to trade. Never mind. Sure, it's fine. Alright, let's just start moving our way around. I forgot about you guys, actually. Oh, thought the game was going to crash. Elect someone for the UP chair. Well, of course myself, but I can't. So I'm going to vote for the Kryn, actually. Actually, the Yor might be our friends. It was the Iridiums. That's fine. Hello, friend. Production specialization. Yeah, I would like that, but... No, the game crashed! But the war... I kind of had a bad feeling, though. There's this horrible bug with the game where sometimes when you try and do a diplomacy, it shits the bed a little bit. And you have to close the screen for the diplomacy you queued up to open. I don't know why that is, but... Oh, man. It's like we started beating ourselves, and the game was like, not feeling it. Alright, hang on, let me try and Control-Delete. Well, this will be where we call it for the night, then. Once we load it up and find out where we are. Because we're right at the end of the War of the Snaggly. Thankfully, they haven't surrendered to some random Yahoo, which would really piss me off. It would be one of the things they just surrender to the Dringan, and you're like, oh. Okay. It's actually an interesting thing, is in the Malevolent Tree, you can get Scare, or like Scare Tactics or something like that. Scary, maybe it's called. Where it's actually a very valid early point, I think, and I feel like it's going to be a very good point regardless of your place in the game. It removes the -1 diplomacy for having shared borders. You know what I mean? That's pretty cool. I didn't take it this time because we're sharing borders with the Drengen and the Snaggly, and the Snaggly I knew we were going to have to be fighting. And the Drengen, they're never going to like you. They sort of like us because we're evil bastards and, you know, we're keeping okay relations, but, war with the Drengen is inevitable as well. It's just going to be a lot of waiting out the economy and trying to recover from this current war, which is really hurting us. Autosave 15. Oh, it was like 3 minutes ago. That's not too bad. Game's like, you thought you could win after you gave me a super powerful custom race? Ha ha! Crashes. You're gonna love my nuts. I love how we have the Snaggly and the minor race Snathi in the game. I wonder if the major race Snathi are somewhere else out there, but I don't think they'd be. Alright, what point am I here? Oh, wow, okay, this is before we did this. And they don't have their entire fleet here this time. Interesting. We still lost a ship to it. Or maybe they just built another one. Could be, I guess. I have no idea. They might have. Yeah, I don't really know what happened. Survey teams are reporting that there's a sudden spike in the number of anomalies being found. I think they're the first to discover its trend, but other races will notice. Of course, we're going to go for malevolent here. No, we're not going to give you money. Sorry, friend. Ideology. Cool. 20% raw production bonus to all our colonies. That's amazing. The heck, the Yor just scared the crap out of me there. Hey, Torian, we're really tired of fighting. We've gone too far down this path. I'm sorry. Alright, let's save it as Torian 2 Crash. And I wonder if I can enforce them to surrender. No, I want Clintsville. Really? Alright. Yeah, no, they're just shitting out shipyards, apparently. Which is odd, because shipyards are not cheap to make. But, oh well. It is what it is. So in 4 turns, I might be able to take this guy out. The SS borrowed bullets. Right on. That's so funny that they used the ships I made. Oh god, that's terrifying. Like, good thing we didn't leave them in the game, or else they would have just, like, produced the massive dong ships. Which, as we all know, are impossible to defeat. That is really funny, actually. So how many turns do you get there? 3? Potentially you could do this in 3 turns. Shipyard idle. I don't really want to build more dolphins, but... I wonder if we got our trading off yet. Like, I have no idea if the trades went off. Snathi, we're big and threatening. Give me money. Oh, aren't you cute? Can I pet you? Oh yeah, I'm allergic to everything. Thanks, Borrowed. I appreciate that. Alright. Potentially we could try it with this. Okay, we got Cities of Learning. Yeah. I would like Educational Focus. Yeah, better research would be cool. Thank you. Because we just need to keep up on our research right now. How many turns to get here? So like 3 turns until we can do it. Alright, let's do a save. We're going to save here and see if we'd be able to win this with everything. Okay, so answer is no. They do actually fight with all 7 at once. Is that right? Shit. That's crazy. Okay, I wasn't sure if they'd be able to fight with all 7 at once. So, the only way to beat that then... Focus universities is good, but we have to change our diplomacy and get more fleet logistics so we can have more ships. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to do that. Oh, okay. The Snathy just contacted me and gave me a little bit of money. Randonum. I'll take it. I don't get it, but... So, that is governance. And... No, it's not. Protection? Fleet logistics? No. Engineering? Interstellar logistics. 7 turns. Damn cheating squirrels. Yeah. There's Nathy, you're like, hey, we like you now. Okay, do you have anything? Xenobiology production specialization. I like it. It's not the end of the... It's not the best thing ever. If I give you all this stuff here that I don't really care about. You know what? Screw interstellar trade and just give me a bunch of cash. That works, friend. Snathy, what do you got? Oh, yeah. Oh, you have interstellar trade. Okay. And wealthy population? And money? Okay. Crin, what do you got for me? Targeting specialization. Yes. We need that pretty bad, actually. You guys are doing pretty good for tech as well. So. Is there anything else you can give me? Shield specialization is okay. It's not really what I want. I might take it, though. No, I'm not in love with it. What else can we give you? Yeah, probably just this. I mean... We're not really getting a lot out of it, but that's okay. What do you guys have? Anything? Nope. We suck. Alright. Drengen? Oh, Drengen are getting pissed. Shit. So they have medium hulls, which we already knew. Diplomat. Oh, yeah, give me more diplomatic shit. I don't know why you guys have that for some reason, but I'm really happy you do. Production specialization. Potentially give you this. Okay, interstellar governance, I feel like, is the one. Oh, the diplomatic tech they don't want to give up. Oh, they don't want to give anything. Well, they do hate me, so fair enough. I don't actually care about any of that. Sorry, Yori. Shari. So yeah, 7 turns so we can win this. Yeah, I appreciate that, Origami. I think we're okay, though. Alright. I'm just making sure that the 7 that attack are gonna all be our paper crabs. Trying to look like someone took a brute from Halo 2 and shaved it. I agree with you on that. Actually, there you go. That is something I do want, Yor. You don't have any... Do you? I need Durantium. Thulium, no. I'm pretty sure we already traded with everybody else. Yeah, shit. Drengen? Do you have Durantium? Nope. Alright. That's awkward. Yeah. Yeah, well. Win some, you lose some. Well, we are going to need more hermit crabs at some point, so I guess we start building them now. Probably makes sense. Idle colony. Yeah, this one we need more Hydroponic farms. This one, I forget what I was building here. Probably... Well, this is Fabre, yeah. Manufacturing capital is tempting, but we are going to have to throw that on another planet, so... Pass for now. Okay, we need a farm here. And... Just a factory. So where do we start building these? Well, the Drengen are going to be a problem, we know that. So building something over here is not a terrible idea. Shipyards would be cool as well, actually. Fabror is a pretty powerful place to get a shipyard up and running, actually. So let's do that. Okay, you go ahead and guard. How long? 6 turns. I really want that now, so we're going to set a bit of a research focus on the home planet. Okay, yeah, you just get... Apparently that's really far away from Fabror. Oh, I see. This one finally got built. Oh, interesting. There we go. It's fine. Well, I didn't expect this to ever get built, so... It's weird. Nice. Not too bad. Not too bad. And we probably go for some random culture star bases, which may seem odd. Perhaps it is. Yeah, just get working on hermit crabs, actually. If I need to change my mind, I'll change my mind. So I really want to take Snaggly out of the game, and then there'll be a nice place to end, I think. Just that perfect feeling of, ah, we did it, boys. Let's go build a star base over here and just piss them off. Yeah, go ahead. Oh, disband. Oh, oops, that was awkward. Oh, yeah, we can't create a fleet with it yet. Alright, oops. So, no, you're guarding, and you just guard. Minus 10 per turn. Oh, well. Nope, can't give you that. Sorry, pal. Alright. We're going to need a star base for this guy as well. An economic one. Going to need an economic star base here. So, I guess we'll start doing that soon. I think we can build... Who's he too close to? Oh, that one. Should be able to do it there. How about that one? Oh, maybe not. There we go, perfect. Get our economic starbase going for Fabror. Just all the stuff. Don't need that yet. Don't need trade stations. We could actually... That is something we could be doing instead of this. Getting some trade ships. That's so funny, that little planet. Poor bastard. I guess we just build a random culture one here. That'll be fine. Okay, perfect. We have it done. Interstellar logistics. I like it. Zero gravity construction. Hopefully we actually win the war with this so we can get back to research. Let's disband this fleet. What's in that? A bunch of dolphins, actually. Hang on. There we go. 8 ships. Have fun, pal. So, let's take our 8 ships and victory likely. There we go. Perfect. View the battle, of course. This is going to be the ultimate fight. They have larger ships than we do, but our ships are more maneuverable and we're packing. Oh, yeah. Just get wrecked. Sail away. Invading fleet. Likelihood of success only 50%. Biological warfare makes that 100% done. When we finally kill the Snaggly. Ah, I finally beat myself off these planets. Yes. Yep. Correct. Okay, we're going to have to do that. They built this weird. Unfortunately, we lost so many good ships, so many good men. That's alright. Let's get over here then. Defend with those fools, and yeah, I guess actually you guys can defend Kluntzfeld. That'll be fine. So yeah, that'll be alright too. We really need some more paper crabs. Well, we don't, because the war's over. So we'll put it on the back burner. We do, though, need another transport ship, because I feel like I don't have one anywhere. Shit. Whoops. That was silly of me. I'm going to need that for their last planet. All right, let's get Title Mark 2 up here. Oh, that was a paper crab. You know what? Actually, let's redesign this Mark II. Yeah. Don't crash. Okay. Let's get another hyperdrive plus on this bad boy. Okay, so now it moves a little faster. 6.6 movement. A spawner? What the fuck? Oh. That's fine. Let's just not worry about it. That's fine. Title. All the way to the top. And then we should meet them over at RBS around the same time. And then the Drengen will be next. Okay, so they are trying to fight me. They do have transport ships. I'm really fucking sad about that. That was pretty clever on their part. Did they win? Yes, probably. Just hasn't updated yet. No? Huh? I guess the answer was no. Well, alright, then. I think it bugged out, because those ships are still there. Okay, they just had a stack. That was weird. Alright, well, that's good. I see, they salvaged my dolphin. I was like, why the heck do they have a dolphin? Fair enough, they'll do that. Alright, well, how long on the first of our paper crabs? I guess we do need them now, boys. Wasn't intending on it, but idle colony? Yes, more of the farm thing. Okay, so start heading here. Okay, now they're running away. That's what I thought, boys. No, I'm not going to give you any money. Sorry, Yor. Okay, their starbase is gone now. Which is interesting. Alright, 4 turns to get here. Let's go. Certainly don't need all these guys, but it's too late now. Culture, yep. We don't have a lot of cultural tech, and we're not really worrying about it right now. But we're doing a thing. And how long would it take me to get here? 3 turns. Oh yeah, not too bad. I wonder if anyone's been hiring the mercenaries. I wouldn't imagine so. But who knows? Either way, let's get a economic starbase going here. It's fine, we don't really need the recreation center. Not yet, anyway. You guys just work on, I guess, research. Don't really need anything else from you right now. Money be nice, but eh. Oh, we almost got this though, boys. The war's almost over. Snathi are almost out of the game. They're fighting me with my own thing. You dick. It's pointless to continue this war. I don't think you understand what you started, son. Sure, was I thinking about the war at the beginning of it? Yeah. But am I the one who declared war? No. I was just protecting my interests, you know? I wasn't actually going to do it. As Herpy would say, it was just a prank, bro. But you made it personal. So, can I declare war on these guys yet? 15 ships now defending. They're all crappy, though, so... Oh, thanks, Yor, for that gift of friendship. I really like that money you gave me for free. Thank you. I think we get another... Oh. Okay, good, I already made that economic. Let's get another culture ring going. I really like the Torian race, I think they look quite nice. I think their stuff is pretty cool. More research. Yep, we really need that. Absolutely. Reduce maintenance or plus one food. Wow, 3 turns for plus one food. Solid. Can't argue with that. Get dunked. Uh, 99% victory chance. I'll take it. The Snaggly have been destroyed. Yeah, well, they tried. So now there's a lot of pirate star bases around, sadly. Something to keep in mind. Cultural relic. Somebody here is mining all that stuff. I would like it. Unfortunately, you don't just automatically get all their star bases, which is a little frustrating. They're all pirate star bases now, and you have to go around and, you know, whatever. Man, Cluntsville. It's been a while. How are you doing? Not bad, that's good. I like the fact that you've absolutely no money coming in and no research and everything sucks here. Why don't you go ahead and destroy that thing for me and build an intimidation center? That'd be cool. Alright, RBS, guess what? It's intimidation center, yep, that's gonna happen. So this is a research thing. I like it. Out of everywhere, this is probably one of the better built planets. The AI is done. Did I declare war? No, you did. Was I about to invade your planet? Yes, but you declared war for us. Space politics, bitch, I'm in the right. That's how you do it, Borrowed, yeah, absolutely. Alright, you don't know what you're doing. I don't know what you're doing. Just get down here and do some culture and piss off the Dringan. That's a good idea. Here, why don't we meet up with this guy somewhere? Figure things out. Is that another paper crab? Yeah, it is. Nice. What do you think? Would that be enough? Yeah, we could totally take him. Nice. So four turns, I'll take it. Idle colony. You already got that thing built. We just needed this thing built. I'm happy with it. Yeah, absolutely no manufacturing going on here, so not really gonna worry about the thing. Surely we can declare war on these guys now. Yeah, more research. Because again, our race does get a research bonus. We should probably do our best to get that going. Speaking of, Mr. Rollitz Derp, how is your building of the things? Very slowly. Get that thing. Please. In fact, Rollitz Derp, do you have another... No, not yet. Okay, I really need this now. That's fine. Idle colony. Yeah, fair enough, you're not doing anything. Economic research. Neither of these are amazing. I guess we'll just do research. We'll worry about the budget later. Mm-hmm. Okay. So he just threatened me. Dringan, do you know who I am? I'm the man who killed the other guys. Oh yeah, you really are pissed. You're ripe for conquest. Really? My military's only 6th. Well, that's fair, I suppose. We should probably be focusing more on... Well, actually, does anybody have that technology that I can trade, maybe? Zero gravity construction, perfect. Yeah, I know you're not going to want to part with that very easily, but you and I could potentially be friends. No, really? Okay. What is this shit? Oh yeah, Toria would be fine. So where is yours, homeworld? Actually, we want to trade with the Dringan. I don't know where their homeworld is, though. We're just going to send it here. We just want to get a quick diplomacy bonus with them. Speaking of, actually... okay, we already have... Oh, no. Open borders. Sadly, has passed. Will you trade me this at all? No? Oh, they just declared war on me during that diplomacy screen. In order to better assist all the races of the galaxy, the UP elects a chair being that will lead blah blah blue. The Yor. Hey, the Yor one. Cool. So yeah, they literally just declared war on me. That's awkward. Kind of weird they declared war on my turn during the thing. Why are you mad at me? Oh, shared borders. Even though you loved me for the entirety of the game, but now you hate me because my military got a little low? It's kind of random. Alright. Here, just pay me a little bit of money. Does anyone border? You do. The Kryn? Yeah, hey Kryn, you and I aren't super friends. You won't declare war on the Dringan, eh? It's not happening? Alright. Interesting. Wow, what a turn of events. Hold the door! I'm trying, Spencer, what's up? Yeah, declare one of these guys, why not? Spencer's here in the stream, yeah. Oh my goodness, they have so many ships, though. Still. Get wrecked. Alright, well, let's go ahead and conquer their terrible little planet. And then we'll try and deal with the Drengen, which is going to be 65% chance. I could pay 500 credits for 100. I can't really afford 500 credits. We lost. Oh well, it's the way she goes. Time to... wait, not this one. Where's my other... nah, this one. Oh, not the M1, the M2, thanks. That'll do. Yeah, now we just need to get our death furnace up and running. Got another trade ship. We're gonna send this over to the Hot Brainia system, apparently. We do want to trade with the Kryn, though. Yeah, we need corpses. I totally agree with you on that one there, Bard. Alright, I'll leave this ship here to kill all their other ships, and then head over to the Draken, which is most likely where they're going to attack from. Just guard. You'll be alright. So we can get a military starbase up here. Should be good. Yeah, I'm not... I know the Drengen think they're hot shit right now. But I'm not sure they are. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they had a super military that we didn't know about, don't get me wrong. That'll be the Drengen for you. Yeah, it's got a military ring, of course, starbase defense system, and advanced defenses, and perimeter scanners. But, like, I'm not certain they're as good as they want me to believe. All I'm saying. Okay, they are attacking one of my star bases. I mean, I feel like I should win this fight, but... yeah. See, I don't know why they attacked that star base. It was a culture star base. I can get that. Oh, they're blowing up one of my other culture star bases. They do hate your culture star bases. The Drengen do one thing, they hate that. And what is this? Oh, just one of my scout ships in their territory. That's alright. It's not perfect, but... okay, let's go ahead and set up yet another title. And we're going to need more paper crabs, of course. So where'd the Drengen go? They were right here. They couldn't have gone far. Apparently they did. Huh. How about that? Well, it's interesting. I don't really know what my plan was with you. Oh shit, 6 a.m. Anyway, sorry guys. I guess we'll call it here. I think I just saved. I don't know. Anyway, recently. But, that'll be it for now. Got a pretty good start. Drengen are always Drengen. Whenever you spawn beside them, you're in for a bad game. But we did manage to take out the Snaggly first. I'm really surprised that everyone thinks our military is crap, but that's the way she goes, as it were. But yeah, I will talk to you guys tomorrow night, as per usual. And take it easy, get some good sleep and all that kind of cool stuff. And yeah, see you then.